I'm here with Roy, Executive Chairman at HP Energy, and I know that you're looking to distribute this new eCactus battery. Now, there's a lot of products here, a lot of batteries, a lot of inverters. What sets this apart from the rest?
That's a very good question, Zach. We've been very taken with eCactus because we look at this marketplace and we're looking at the fact that in Australia there are already 3.25 million solar rooftops, but there are less than 100,000 holders of batteries. And so on that basis, it's telling you there's a significant mismatch. So immediately there's a market for those who have solar but no battery. And also, if you look at the potential in the marketplace, that figure of 3.25 million can double in the next 5 years. And those people should be looking to have concurrently battery systems installed. Now, what constitutes the best value? If you look at an average house, they are 21 kilowatt hours consumption a day. And that normally would require a 6.6 kilowatt solar array, then coupled with a 10.2 kilowatt hour battery. This is a 10.2 kilowatt hour battery. As you can see, it's slim, compact, and also it has some aesthetic qualities, which not all batteries do have. It also has a hybrid all-in-one battery storage system and the inverter. So you actually have this all-in-one piece here. You don't need a separate inverter. So this is a versatile piece of equipment. It's technologically advanced. It was only released in 2021. So we're looking at something that is now in the marketplace, fit for purpose, and really being part of the rollout to the next 3.25 million people, but with a battery system rather than just solar. One of the other added advantages, of course, is that this also has a UPS, an uninterrupted power supply, and that is a tremendous value to customers because you've got the ability to switch within 10 milliseconds, so you wouldn't notice it on your computer, and this is a tremendous advantage. So we love the versatility, we like its compactness, but most efficient, most importantly, we love the economics. This is a highly competitive piece of technology that actually will be very attractive to customers.
So you're going to be a key distributor. What sort of numbers are you looking into the future for this battery and inverter combo?
Exactly. That, again, is a very good question. So, as I said before, the potential now for concurrent solar panels and battery systems is significant. And that's going to, I think, dominate the next 5 years. This will be ideally on the marketplace, and we're looking in, certainly in the next year, to sell between 3,000 to 5,000 of these systems. Thereafter, we would see that figure doubling for at least the next 2 years. What I think is most important is, of course, that the value of this is recognized in the marketplace and recognized by government policy with regard to the appropriate subsidies. So for example, the small technology certificates you get for solar panels, they will expire in 2030. I must admit, I'd love to see those extended so that we can actually see the full potential of this released onto the marketplace.
Yeah, a lot of exciting stuff, and honestly, it is a great system. Like, just looking at it here, it really looks sleek. Really looks like it could fit almost anywhere. So I'm looking forward to this release, and I'm really looking forward to seeing how it can do in the industry, and yeah, it's just reaching its full potential.
And Zach, that's a very good point you make there. This should have great appeal for the residential market, but also for the SMEs, and for those SMEs who are concerned about their carbon footprint, because this will enable both the home and the SMEs to reduce materially their carbon footprint.
For sure. Well, thank you for being with us today, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your All Energy.